I am now access level 2, which means I can open access level 2 doors. It's a weird game, is the point. Okay. Oh, okay, yes, I'll explain that. It actually took me a while to figure out. So the idea is your guy starts at level 1, your slug cat, and in order to get further through the game, there are a set of locked... Oh, god damn it, where am I? Oh, hey, there's a passageway down here I didn't find. Neat. Cool. I may explore that later. Yes, oh, crap. Yeah, I guess we'll explore this now. There's no real downside to it, except for all the guys with spears. All right, yes, as I was saying. So your kitten, your slug kitten here, has the ability to pass levels. And so there are certain areas that are locked off by a door. And only if you are a certain level can you go through that door. And as a consequence, so the first level... There we go. To get from the area 1 to the area I'm in now... No, the area I was before. Sorry, this is the area 3. Area 2, you had to get a... become level 3. So you have to eat a bunch of food, then hibernate to get to level 2. Then you have to eat a bunch of food, and then hibernate to get to level 3. And then, and only then... Come on. Whoa! Kitten? I'm playing a kitten who's an acrobat, and that feels great. Yes, so you have to go and you have to feed and hibernate all without dying, and that is the only way to get to the next area, as far as I can tell. I mean, I'm not great at this game. I only started playing it yesterday, and I have died a lot. Oh my god. We are across the bridge, finally. Whew! Or now we're in some kind of a sewer-looking place. One of many kind of sewer-looking places in the game. Alright. How are we doing time-wise? Oh god, yeah, only a quarter of the day done. Food! I kinda like the way he poses with the spear. Ah! Very easy to push stuff around accidentally. Alright, I'm gonna grab some more food. Get delished, my dear. Okay. Ugh. Okay. Nice! Yeah, well, what it is there are glowing flowers you can eat. Apparently, I have to become level 3 or 4 to get past this. Huh. That's not good. You only have to be level 2 to get back the other way. So, let's take a nap. And hope I don't have to wheedle my way back across the bridge. Let's hope I only have to be level 3. Because if I only have to be level 3, we're getting through to the next area. That'll be great. Oh, kitten! Oh. No, I agree. It is troublesome. It is a bad gameplay design, because it kind of discourages you from exploring the game. Oh, thank God, we only have to be level 3. Oh. Alright, here we go. And you don't have to be level 2 to go back the other way, although I don't know why you ever would. Ow. Actually, kind of like the airlock animation. All right, so now job one is to find four pieces of food and immediately save on the other side of this door so I don't have to do that again. And there's the food right there. Wow. It's like the game knew exactly what I wanted. Of course it did. No, no. There's so much food. Yeah, every now and then. Actually, funny thing. You can see it on the... I made a video of it. You can see it elsewhere on the channel. So I had never heard of JoJo's Bizarre Adventure. Right? I had completely missed it. Right? I had no idea the thing existed. And so I got a review copy of the game for the PS4. So it's like, here's this brand new thing that I've never heard of. And it was apparently a fairly popular manga and anime. So I got to go in completely fresh, and I was kind of... Yeah, exactly. I was kind of blown away. What the hell was that? All right, we're gonna go save before we do any more of this. So I had... I know. So I went and I played the whole game, which was a lot of fun. It was like super weird, super crazy. Really enjoyed it. And so I went and I read the first volume of the comic book, and I'm like, okay, yeah, I definitely got to read more of this because I was blown away by the first, back when it was set in Victorian times. I understand it jumps, as I saw from the video game, it jumps back and forth through history quite a bit. But yeah, I read the first volume that was set in Victoria times, and I really enjoyed it. So yeah, I'm definitely going to check out more of JoJo's Bizarre Adventure. Apparently the pieces of the corpse you were picking up the whole time through the game was Jesus's corpse. They leave that out of the video game. They just talk about a holy corpse, and I'm like, I guess I should have figured out it was Jesus's corpse? But, yeah. Oh, what? You don't have to explain the whole thing. I was planning on reading it anyway. I mean, I always need a new thing to read, and honestly, JoJo seems amazing. I mean, it'll probably never replace my love for Fist of the North Star, but that's because I'm a crazy person who loves Fist of the North Star. So apparently if I have a spear, it tells me spear something on that thing. So I'm going to see if I can find a spear and try that. Or just any weapon. Okay, here we go. All right, so I'm trying to try throwing a weapon at this thing. Oh, okay. So I hit that, and it did nothing. Maybe if I had a spear, right? Can I jump across to get that, or is that a no-go? Yes! Oh, yeah, no, and that was clear right away from the beginning. Like, the game just seems to be a greatest hits, jumping through and meeting locations and characters that appeared in the manga. Like, they go out of their way to say in the game, and it's like, wait, what are you doing here? You got killed! And then is his name Dio? Anyway, it's all like, yes! Through the powers of me being of heaven now, I can bring everybody back to life for plot reasons. I'm being chased by a giant monster. What? Okay, that sucked. Okay, and now we've reached the swimming part of the game, apparently. I thought I drowned if I got in water. Okay. Okay, it is Dio. Alright. Okay, I got some more food. Okay, what is this thing? So it's blue and it looks like food, but it's not food. Okay. Yeah, the thing I liked most about the kind of... And I know this is a weird thing to fixate on, but... and this is something else I'm making a video of. Because I've got all the evidence. That I noticed in the... Okay, I drowned, apparently. I guess. You can't stay underwater too long or you drown, although the game does not in any way tell you that. Here we go. Now let's try that again. Yes, the thing I noticed about the video game, and I hope it's in the anime as well, but I haven't seen that, and manga, is people have this love in it of dramatically appearing at the top of a staircase, and or from a ledge, and looking down at other people. And I'm like, I just like the visual of that. And so I'm going to make a video of the 12 times that happens in the video game. Delish! But yeah, no, I put all of the story segments of the video game on the channel, because, again, it's so crazy. I feel like I have to avoid those giant tentacle monsters. Well, no, I'm saying, but I drown, I get killed by the rain, but I'm just saying, then you're allowed to swim. So I thought the game would be a little kinder for the amount of time I could swim than have me basically instantly die. Also, maybe it's just me. I couldn't see me at all when I was swimming. Whoa, hey there. Here we go. Nope. I'm trying to do my pounce jump. But you're right. I should have assumed I could drown. That one was on me. Damn it! I really thought I could jump across there. Alright, so. I don't like the way I basically completely disappear when I'm in the water. I can't see myself at all. So I'm finding it really hard to get into that entrance. Alright, so there I am. Okay. I guess what I'm trying to say is an audio cue letting me know when I'm about to die. Exactly, right? Like, an audio cue letting me know when I'm about to die would not go amiss, is what I'm saying. I would have appreciated that. Alright, here we go. So I have to get to that streaming water. And then I will... There I am. Okay, I can see me. And then I will take a breath. No. And then I will go and I will swim the rest of the way. Yay! Go, slug cat, go! Alright, leap across. No, that didn't happen. And now I'm trapped. No! Alright, so I guess I have to go down. Which is gonna suck. No, you're not supposed to go down. You are not supposed to go down. There is not another screen down there. But maybe if I go down a bunch, I can use the power of surfacing to make me jump higher. Nope, that didn't work. Alright, let me try this again. I'm not even sure what killed me that time, because I did not spend a lot of time underwater that time. Well, you know what they say. Every game needs a terrible water level. And given how much of trouble I'm already having with the regular levels in the game, I feel like we knew this was going to go terribly. Alright, here we go. Jump! Okay. Yay! A big snake thing will eat me in a single bite. That... Okay, I did not know that. That is not good. Alright, so, when I went down underwater, going left... going right got me killed immediately. So this time I'm going to try going left. I attempted to do a heroic jump, and then I did not get as far as I wanted to, and I died. So, there we go. Wow, I do not like the look of that seaweed snake monster. Which, by the way, might be the least controversial thing I've ever said in my life. I don't like the look of that seaweed snake monster. No one is going to be debating that point with me. No one's going to be like, I want to see what that seaweed snake monster thing has to say. Oh, thank God. Where am I? Oh, good. This doesn't feel safe. Come on. Is that not a thing I can grab onto? It is, right? Yes! My idea of ducking down through the water and then, what do you call it? Ducking down through the water and then using my extra momentum to carry me back up actually worked. Okay. What?! That's a good idea. So if you go down, there's tentacle monsters in the water, and if you go up, there's sky snake beasts. It's a real damned if you do type of situation. Hey, it's a bat! I caught a bat! That was awesome. Where am I? Hey, Matt. Is that a way I can go down? Yes! Alright! We seem to kind of be making progress. Kind of. Ish. There's a lot more bats. I don't know if I can get up there to eat them, but it's good to know they're there. Ah, there we go. Delish. Alright, we now have full food. I'm ready to take on the world. No, I'm ready to find a new place to nap is what I'm ready to do. Alright, what's next? Oh wow, an island! And a place where you can swim under the island. Oh hell. What is that? Brand new kind of snake, everybody. Jump! And there's the bird. Oh my god. This game just got real. Is there a place? No! There's another snake! What the hell? I keep hoping the bird will just eat them, but that might be pushing it, luck-wise. So I need to get into that pathway, and he's just sitting there on top of it. Gah! Oh, God. This is bad. No! Oh, God damn it! I feel like I was really doing okay there for a second. Like, I really had a smooth transition. My skill level was right at where we needed to be. For a second. Oh, and now the music has continued playing, letting me know that, yeah, we're gonna keep that music of you failing playing. At least now this, now I know which way to go is the point. What?! Boop. That's delicious number one. So that was a mistake. I was trying to grab food and it went horribly awry. Okay. Alright, so let's be way more careful this time than I've been. All right. Yeah, when I'm down to zero health, when I'm down to zero security level, I stop caring about my health because, you know, how could you? Delish. Oh! Really? Are there some trick to beating them or getting around them? Because I have not been having much luck when those monsters turn up. I assume you're talking about the snake lizard things. Okay, here we go. Okay, I gotta get better at this. Oh, come on. What am I doing wrong here, exactly? I wish the game would explain that. Well, that served no purpose. Oh, wow. There is a way back up. Good. I was worried there wasn't going to be a way back up. All right, here we go. We're trying this again. Tightrope cat! Okay. Why would I do that same mistake again? Ugh, HOGuru. Oh, okay. So whatever trick I use to get around them, so the fact that I keep... Oh, I see. So the fact that I keep climbing up poles to get away from them is why they started climbing poles to get... That makes sense. And that's good design. Yay! We did it! Alright, so if I remember correct... Oh, crap! It's a snake! And you can't go left. Yeah, there was nothing I could do there. And this is the problem with random monster generation. Sometimes they'll generate a monster just sitting in the hole you need to go through, and there's absolutely nothing you can do about it. And while I'm all for interesting, innovative monster AI design, the fact that they can just be waiting for you and there's nothing you can do about it, that doesn't feel super super fair. All right, here we go. Food. Okay, here we go. It's a neat game, I'll give it that. I'm unprepared for a lot of what it has to offer, but as someone who loved Out of This World and Heart of the Alien, really basically any big pixel art adventure game. 20 seconds of delay, Jesus, that's terrible. Ugh. But as you said, you are in Brazil and I am in Canada. Apparently I drowned that time. I don't even know how. Like, five times I dropped down there, I swam to the left, and I was fine. That time, I drowned when I was trying to do it. Wow. That is something else. Shoreline, you say? I gotta say, Canada's not bad. I'm very pro-Canada. You won't hear me making any complaints. Okay. All right, here we go. And again, I made that same mistake. Oh my god. Alright, here we go. Let's try this again and have it be a little less embarrassing, shall we? Alright, dancing cat. Yeah, the fact that the cat falls like a stone is what keeps getting me into trouble. Alright, so let's try this again. Let's take a breath. Dive. Left. Like, I know it would spoil the game's aesthetic to, like, give me a breath meter. But there are ways to put in audio and visual cues that I'm running out of air, guys. And you're doing neither. Oh, really? Neat. Ugh. Okay, I missed that. There we go. Alright, we go left, we get to the island of the bats. Eventually. Alright, first we have to get through this nonsense. Or just fall. My god. This is getting embarrassing. I'm just... Oh no! No! That's right, go the other way! Jesus. Thank you. Oh, and now the bird's here. Great. So, just for the record, in case anyone is curious, there is a guy guarding the exit, and on the other side, there's a bird waiting to kill me. And I thought maybe I could lure him into attacking the other guy, but I cannot. No, can't go that way. Oh, thank God. What is happening? No! Oh, wow. All right. Oh, we got this. This is happening this time. I now feel a little more confident about my ability at the really rough swimming controls. Is that a thing to pick up? It is not. Thought I could throw something at that fruit, but no. All right, here we go. All right, slug cat, you're now halfway fed. Okay, here we go. We got this. So no more falling and making foolish mistakes. Just gonna jump straight down. I'm going to fall here, but I'm going to take a breath. Take a breath, and down I go. of the game's many varied creative decisions, I think the one I am least satisfied with is the decision to make you functionally invisible while underwater. We're trying to simulate the fact that your slug can't see anything. Yeah, I get it. But screw you at the same time, though, also. Oh my god. What is happening? There we go. Triangle jumping, you're the worst. Where am I? Oh, right. At least there's not a snake here this time. He said, hoping that continued to be true. Oh, God, I hate this part. Thank you. That was a little less painful than it normally is. All right. So, oh crap. Hey guys, you're not here to kill me, right? Well, luckily I'm here to kill you! If I were better at it, wow. For, you know, a creature whose diet consists like 80% of bats, I think I'd be better at catching them. Yeah, not cool, game. No! Did I get in? I did not get in! Oh my god! Oh! Yeah, the game's weird fascination with having an underwater monster waiting for me when I get through tunnels is not an endearing design choice. Or element. Could I have fed him the bat? Like, if I had thrown the bat at him, would that have worked? I'm still learning, is the point. Alright, let's do it. Oh, there's the thing I can throw. Alright, eat. And then... there we go. That's right, now I don't have to screw around with finding all that food. Yay! Alright. Okay, here we go. We're almost through. And I saw the list of games that were available for review, and I'm like, ah, this slug cat thing. That looks like the kind of thing I can get through in an afternoon. I'll just review that. Little did I know. There's no snakes, right? Like, I'm fine to just swim for a second. All right. Here we go. Okay. Thank you. And what do I do now? Take a breath. We go for it. What if we made it really hard to control the slug cat underwater? Just like, weirdly hard. That'd be good, right? People would love that. Oh my god. What is happening? Thank you. All right, does anybody see any killer snakes? No? All right, me neither. Actually, that thing that came at me there might have been a killer snake. It's just the kind I don't recognize. They look kind of like eels, I guess? Alright, so that's where I have to get. I'm on the lookout for killer snakes. That guy doesn't look friendly. Better get myself to keep from drowning. Down I go. Yeah, so there's a snake just sitting on top of my exit. And now he went through the exit. Great. Oh my god! The seaweed attacked the snake. That's fantastic. Alright. Here we go. Alright, we're making our move. I've almost made it to that continue... Well, it's not a continue point. It's just a place I haven't been yet. Yes, food! Oh, thank god. I was really worried I wasn't going to be able to make that jump back up. Alright, here we go. Oh, what does this go? Actually, I don't want to find out. I just want to get out of here. Oh my god, now I'm being chased by this monstrosity. Yeah, that one I found out the hard way. Yeah, it turns into a basically piece of invisible gray wall. It was not a blast to fight. I think the vulture might be dead. I mean, I'd be really happy about that. Save point. Save point, save point, save point. We did it! We made it! Oh my god! I can't believe that happened. It's him and his buddy, the eyeball guide. Oh my god. I am so happy. So yeah, I was within like 5 seconds of the continue point 2 times I died. Doesn't feel great, but I'm glad it's over. Okay, that's the guy who turns invisible. And those are giant snake tentacles that I don't know what to do about. Whoa! He's also got a tongue that he spits at you! Yeah! Oh my god! What is happening?! I'm being attacked by, like, a giant prawn monster that isn't supposed to be out of the water, but accidentally got out of the water. Oh, and there's a giant tentacle centipede down there. Everything about this part of the game is too stressful. Oh, and there's another continue point. Yeah, I saw that thing. It wasn't fun. So, when I throw those into water, can I eat them then? Or no? Oh, good. I noticed they got puffed up when I threw them into water, so... Oh, the snake? Okay. Now I know. Oh my god! He's telling me that this is the way to, the brain alien monster thing. Brain alien monster thing? Yeah, but that way I almost got killed by a tentacle beast. So, maybe not? I mean, I might try back there in a bit. I want to get to the save point first, is the thing. Kind of, yeah. Okay, can I jump over to that third one, or no? Yes. Alright, let's see what's up here. Oh, good, it's another squid, shrimp, krill thing. Fantastic. So I say we. Well, no, I'll check what's through here first. Some more fruit. Pathway to the left, blockade to the right. All right, so I say we save. Because I got full health again, right? I mean, I know I just saved one screen ago, but bear with me, I'm a coward. Oh, come on. What am I doing wrong here? All right, so I go up. Shimmy. Wait. Up. Yeah, there we go. Yeah, it's time to save. We put the next save screen 3 screens after the previous save screen. Because, yeah, no, being a coward is the only sane decision in this game. Wow. All right, I will continue. We're now level 3, so if we come across a level 3 door, we are set. Can't imagine why the game would, like, so early in the game make me do a level 5 door. But I guess they just wanted you to be ready for anything. So I'm just gonna check back up here. I freaked and panicked when I saw the tentacle monster. But I am gonna look around here and see if it's worth doing. All right, so I came up where? I was planning on just going for 2 hours. And now we're a little over that because, nope, that was the wrong way. We're a little over that because I'm way into the game. But, sorry, is there some. He's telling me the monster is back this, like, the thing I need to get to, the alien head thing, is back this way, but I don't see any exits here. Like, when I went through here, right? There was just a giant tentacle beast. There wasn't like another pathway I could have taken. So I'm going to ignore his advice for now and instead go this way. Boop. So yeah, I am going to be stopping the stream soon because I got to go make some dinner and publish some reviews and then write an outline for a movie. So I've got a full day, is my point. All right, let's see what we can do down here. We got some food, we got 2 doors. I assume I'll die if I try to go south. Okay. All right. This place seems awesome and, like, suspiciously safe. What's he saying? Wait, where's he telling me to go? Oh crap, I couldn't get surfaced because of the downstream. That was bad. And now I'm dead. Yeah, I think you have to be out of the water a certain amount of time for you to catch your breath. And again, one of the many things the game is making clear. Oh. Really? That sounds bad. All right, so I can't go this way. I maybe would have to open that door, which I have no idea how to do. So, did I go down last time or did I go up? It's bad that I don't remember. All right, let's try this one. Nope, this one I definitely didn't do. All right, let's see what we can find. Yes, because the music lets you know there's a monster around, right? Hey, I'm in a like a missile silo. Boss. And there's some food. Thank you. You know, after giving me all this food, I feel like there's probably a trap going up here. But I guess we'll see. Oh, there's a pathway. Oh, crap. Alright, is this a trap? No, it's just kind of a beautiful, idyllic area. Huh. I don't really feel safe going left or right, but I'm glad I found this place. Okay, that was a squid who was shooting out jets of water to propel it through the air. Oh, you mean when I'm planning to play this one? I was not planning, don't worry. What? No! The eels are after me! Oh, they gave up. Okay, eels are quitters. Good to know. It is weirdly hard to swim into the right thing. There we go. Oh, that looks bad. Oh my god. Music is getting boss again. More food? Yes, thank you. Brand new island completely free of monsters? Yes, very much, thank you. Alright, so there's an exit down there. Can I get across to the other side? I feel like I can't. Oh, I can. Except there's jellyfish in there. And the jellyfish will definitely kill me. Unless I scare them off with firecrackers. Wow, that firecrackers did not scare the, You know, I'm right there with you about water you can't see the bottom of. I am not a fan. Oh, the bird's here. Well, that didn't work. Maybe you want to eat some jellyfish instead of me, huh? Oh my god! He is really getting his head locked in there. Alright, I think that's that. I think for everyone's sanity's sake, I should probably take a break from Slugcat the game, which I've been enjoying the hell out of, don't get me wrong, but I feel like I'm losing my ability to focus and achieve at a level that the game requires. So yeah, I guess Shoreline, you say. Alright. No, absolutely. Send me a message on... I'll send you a message over the... the seeds you can make bigger in the blue water. We discovered that a little bit ago. More points. Ooh. That does sound good. I will definitely try that. Next time I get a blue fruit. But I'm gonna try this area one more time, and then we will wrap up the stream. So I'm gonna say some details now for the gradual get away from me, seaweed! Goodbye. I've been the Hidden Object Guru. Thanks for coming along on this journey with me. If you had a good time, please like and subscribe. Of course. Toin Ho BR, I will absolutely Adler. Send you a message over YouTube. YouTube. Steam and over YouTube. If you want to run me through how to make a... Alright, so can I throw this? I really thought they might want to eat that, but it just does, looks like nobody wants that stuff. Oh, there's a snake over by the exit. So, yeah, I guess I am going to try to go this way. Alright, so let's, first off, let's eat. So I'm not crazy. I really don't like the way those snakes have it of camping by the, by the exit. That was a really frustrating ability for them to learn. That was awesome. Hey, I can grab the, I was scared of being killed by the jellyfish. You can just pick them up. What the hell? I think that squid just gave me a fruit. I threw the fruit in the water, and then the squid grabbed it, and he jumped out here, and he threw the fruit back at me. This game is so confusing. I think I might have found another dead end. Can I go left or right? Oh, it's over here. Wait a minute. What? There was another entrance right here? Oh, good. This jerk. I hate him so much. Yeah, you can just pick up a... Oh, crap! Here. Why does no one like to eat, Faster, faster, faster! Get to the air! Nope, he drowned. Alright, well, there's your lesson. Thanks for coming along this journey with me. I will be back here on Wednesday for more Slug Cat. If you want to, I know. I always tweet GC_Danny half an hour before I'm going to be doing a stream, so I will give everybody a heads up that way. And if I can figure out some way to also, and I think it also notifies you on YouTube when I'm starting a stream, so if you want to be back for that. So, anyway, thanks again, and I will see you back here for the next thing.